All right, I actually made it home. Happy New Year. It's what, Tuesday evening? So yes, New Year's Eve. My wife got this all hooked up. Happy New Year. We're going to keep the lights on until the new year. And we're going to play this game of Monopoly. This is actually Bentonopoly, which is the town that we live in currently. And it's got actually all the names. I'm sure you guys got one for your city as well. So we got big news. I'm going to be here for half the day tomorrow, Wednesday, which means you're going to get to see some work on the Toyota at the end of this video. So we are planning on going to Mininats. Mininats registration opens at midnight tonight. Is when the registration's open. Now remember that they can only have 700 people registered. So we're gonna have to get on there at 11 o'clock, which that would be 12 o'clock Eastern, and we're going to see if we can get registration for it. Wish us luck. You'll actually know like right after I get done talking whether it worked or not. So we will let you know in here just a minute. What was some of the other stuff? Yeah, that's the midweek video. We'll talk to you guys in the morning, right? So, yep. Happy New Year, everybody. Happy New Year. Yeah. Talk to you guys in a little bit. So, it's what, 9 o'clock a.m. My wife's already gone to work. My daughter's already gone to the babysitters. I'm about to go outside. Oh. Did we make registration? Hell yeah, we did. Right at the stroke of 11 o'clock our time, which is midnight Eastern time, I refreshed the screen. Boom. Registration popped up. I started filling that sumbitch out. I heard in 2 hours, Mini Truck Nationals was sold out. 700 registrations done in 2 hours. There's so many people that didn't get in. And I really feel bad for all of you that didn't get in. But if you didn't get in, I've heard the whole place, the whole Maggie Valley area turns into like a car show, mini truck, everything town. So, I mean, if you didn't make registration, come out anyway. Come out. I'd like to meet all of you. Whoever can make it, man, find me. We're going to have the Toyota there. It will be there. Crunch time starts now. I've got literally 14 days to finish bagging that truck. Now, it may not be 100% all the way done, but it's going to be pretty damn close. And we plan on driving it out there. Unless we see any kind of complications or whatever, we may end up trailering it. But right now, the plan is to drive it out there. So, without further ado, let's get out there and start building this mini truck. All right, we had a game delay. My buddy Charlie Johnson, some people call him Chuck, up there in Wisconsin, gave me a phone call. So, I took the opportunity while I was talking to him. I removed all their Christmas lights, got everything down. Christmas is put away, basically. We just got a few things inside. But yeah, no time wasted, because I was going to do that this weekend. Now I don't have to do that this weekend. And it's still, what time is it? 9:42. So I still got at least, I want to say 3 hours I can put in on this. It shouldn't take me more than an hour to get the other bag mount on. I got to finish welding this side up right here. I think I had just a little piece in there that needs to be welded in. I need to clean all that up, and I need to make a template for that piece right there and drill a hole in that for the bag. But I got to get the bag mounted up in there, which means I need to get all that excess slag and stuff off right in there. And then we'll move over here and put this bag mount in. The upper shock mount will end up going right in here. That's usually where it'll slide right up into there and then attach to the lower control arm.
So, that's the same thing on the other side. Got my Dremel out with a little sander. That way I can try to knock off some of the slag off the frame and get that done. Just got done talking to Tommy Flanagan. What's up, buddy? This is what you were talking to me while I was doing this. What we're looking at is what we need to do, okay? I don't have the bottom bolt in just yet because I have not, drilled a hole yet. What I'm doing is I'm trying to get this bag positioned far enough back to where it's supported on the lower bag mount. But also, we got to look at stuff like this. That's where that bag is going to rub. So I put a mark in there to make sure that I need to grind some of that out so that it'll make it around that. Same thing on this side. See, we've got that right there. And we've got this right here. You need to check everywhere before you get something mounted up as to what it might rub. This isn't needed. So we're just going to go ahead and cut this off right there. And then all that. But I got it. Pretty much all of the slag cleaned off. There's some spots that I can't really get to because I don't have proper tools to be able to get to them, but it's going to be okay. The bolts are mounted up here. Airline will come up through that like that, and then that way it's out of the way. So yeah, I'm going to make some marks. I'm going to take a screw. Look at, where is it? Where's my screw? There it is. And I'm going to put it under here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a mark on the bag. Because see, then what I'm going to do is I'm going to measure how far back it is from there to the hole. And then I can measure from here back to where I got to drill the hole. And then I can go ahead and mount this bag. Boom. Let me get that done. And I'm going to go ahead and grind and cut all that shit out while I'm at it. All right, I got it brought back down, and I've got a mark in here. I got to measure from there back, and then I made a mark here where the center is on the bag, so I'll measure from here back, and I'll drill a hole in the middle of this plate, and then that way I can go ahead and lift it up, and then when I lift it up, I'll take this airline out so I can release this, and then I can bend this down while I bring that up and get that bolt mounted in there and then get it tightened up. That way this bag will be mounted and I can move to the other side, but I still got to cut those pieces out. I just want to get that hole drilled. That way I can do all the cleanup needed before I'm actually done. All right, it's still rubbing just a hair over here. I still got a little bit more to shave, but other than that, it's not rubbing anywhere else when it's laid out. I got this airline coming off of here, and it goes over to one of these so that I can do a test. I'm going to set it up to this and get this hooked up. And then all I got to do is air this up and watch. I'm not going to air it up all the way because it's still sitting on all the blocks, but that's why you guys can see that it's going to work. So now I got to get in here and see where everything else is. I just raised it up about an inch off the blocks, so I'm not going to do anything else, but we can take this out and release this. Turn it the right way. And there's that. Minimal effort to lift it. Now I got to start figuring out the other side. The only thing left on this side is to clean everything up, paint it. I did notice that this right here bumps the top of the bag mount. So if I wanted this to be able to get a little bit more lift, if I notch this out right here, notch that out right there. Of course, in the end, doing your own upper control arms with a tube going out here to a plate and then back down to here would open all this up. I know on my Mazda years ago, I just cut all this out. So then that way it would get more lift. I mean, the thought is there. I don't know if I'm actually going to do that because it takes away from all of it. Oh, I just realized I wasn't pointing at it. But yeah, no, I cut out all of this right here and all the way down. But I may end up cutting out just this piece here and this piece here. That way it leaves this and this still connected. And this ends up connecting here and there. So that way it'll still go a little bit beyond it. Beyond it would end up slightly running into the bag. So we'll see. I mean, that's just something in the future. Of course, getting all of this remounted on there to be able to do any more test fitting and whatnot. And then, of course, right in here, mounting the shock tower, which we'll probably end up having to move this over just a hair, which got to grind that out. And then this can actually unbolt here. Can you still see what I'm pointing at? Yeah. Unbolt here and here, and that can actually be slid back a little bit further to fit all that in there. So plenty more to do right in here just to finish it up and make it look proper. But other than that, bag mounts are in. Let's check out that. Or one bag mount is in. Let's go ahead and hook this up again. There. And then we will do like this. Woo, it wants to lift up quickly. That wasn't nothing important. But before I drop it back down, I might want to go look at it, maybe. I don't know. Let's see if we can get everything to fall over there. Okay, no, actually what it was the spindle on the other side, spinder and the brake rotor on the other side that fell off because it was leaning up on the side over there. So, all right, that's enough playing with this and being excited. I need to take the fucking bag mount off, and then I need to get all that painted up just as best as I can right now to keep it from rusting over again and grind a little bit more out on this side. So yeah, here we go. All right, got everything cleaned up. Got this one painted up.
What are you doing today?
And then got that plate in there. Everything's not 100% beautiful, but it's all gonna hold. And I've got it all done right there. So now I just gotta wait for this to dry a little bit, and then I'm gonna go ahead and put the bag in there. All right, no air in it, but now we've got everything back together the way it came out. Got the bag mounted in there. I just wanted to show you guys what it looked like. I did have a problem. I turned this all the way this way. This brake line was touching the bag there. This one was touching the bag up here. And that'll be when it's fully extended and turned all the way. So if I have it all the way up in the air and I've got it all the way turned to the right, that's going to end up rubbing. So I bent that up just a hair, that way that would give a little bit more slack out this way, and then bent that back in that direction, because when you pull it back in the other direction to turn it, see if I can do this with one hand, it extends. You got to watch that brake line, because think about it, it's like a 30-year-old brake line, but it still has enough slack there that it's not gonna hurt nothing. And then you gotta watch those, so when they're going back and forth, they don't end up hitting your bag either. So everything seems to be good, all on the up and up. I'm gonna go ahead and get the wheel on here, throw that airline on there so that we can kinda air it up a little bit here and there to see what it looks like. All right, we got it all up in the air. Now we just need to give it a little bit of a test. If I can find all the attachments I need. Jeez, I got too much stuff. Okay. There's that. We don't wanna always wanna shut your valve off when you first do this so you don't end up hitting it with full pressure of your tank. Then we're just gonna give it a little bit of air, lift it up.
Got a little bit of a leak, but let's get it up there up. Plus I didn't push my airline in tight enough. Not everything works exactly the way you want it to. All the time. Damn. It's a little harder to get to all this once you have it all together. See if we can get this in there a little better than what we had it. Hungry.
Are you thungry?
Yes, I am. Hangry. That's why nothing's working. Hell, I can't even get the airline back in there now. I guess I'm not gonna get this in. There we go. Whether it actually works or not, that's the next. There we go. That's a little better. We were able to lift it up.
How far did we go?
I don't want to lift it too far because there we go. That gets it off the ground about an inch. I don't want to go too much farther because the way it's on the blocks, it can shift. But anyway, there we go. Now we just let it back down. I need to get it on the ground, but I'll mess with all that this weekend. That's it. That's the end of the midweek video. Please subscribe if you haven't subscribed already, if you can even hear me. Thumbs up for getting the passenger side done. Give me some comments. Are you going to be at Mini Nats? Let me know. See y'all later.